So today I'm going to be referencing an origami model by this book, The New Origami. It's modern origami created by origami artists who are actually alive today. Steve Biddle created this new origami thing. It's a tumbler. It tumbles and it will roll away. So it's a little fun fidget toy. It's pretty satisfying. But the first step to folding this is to fold the bottom edge to the top edge. We're going to use a rectangular printer paper for this too. So just a valley fold. Again, valley fold is called valley fold because it looks like a valley. So it's hard getting this on the screen. Stupid paper. Anyway, then you're going to unfold it. You're going to rotate 90 degrees. And then you're going to fold bottom corner, bottom edge, to the top edge. So, just like that. Then you're going to unfold. And we're gonna fold this edge to this edge. Just fold. So. There we go. Then once we're done with that step, we're gonna fold this edge to this edge, folding diagonally. Again, fold very sharp creases so you get nice, sharp folds. And then you're going to repeat on the other side. So this side to this side. And you're going to make it as precise as you can. You want to take your time. If I'm going too fast, again, pause the video at any time. Then once you're done with that, you're going to fold this corner to this point. So you kind of want to put your finger on this point and hold it down, because when you fold this up, all of these edges will want to slide forward and it'll mess up. But this is just for extra precision. You don't really have to. It'll still work perfectly fine. But if you want to be extra precise and be an overachiever, you can do that and then move your finger away. Then, once you're done with that, you're going to fold this edge up to this edge. One more time, and we're about done. So again, you want to put your finger here for extra precision, and fold up like a crease. That edge wants to slide up, so we'll unfold it. Okay, here we go. It's kind of hard because it's such thick paper, I'm not used to it. Some printer paper. And then when you're done with that, you're gonna rotate 180 degrees. And then you're gonna fold this edge to the center and this edge to the center. So we're just gonna simply valley fold it. Side, as I said before. So I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees for just a little bit so that I can get this fold precise. I'm going to move it up a little bit. So that, you're going to unfold, and now we're going to fold this edge to this edge. So we're gonna fold it diagonally again. And we're gonna valley fold diagonally from this edge to this edge. So we just repeated the step on the other side. And then we're gonna fold this edge in between this invisible crease. Invisible crease right here that you can't see. And that's what we're gonna do, just pretend there's an invisible line. If you want, and it helps, you can grab an extra sheet of paper and you can line it up between those and then fold it with that layer so that you kind of get the proportions right. But if you want, you could just make these points, this point line up with this point, and this point line up with this crease. Once you're done with that, you're going to fold it over again and recrease on this side. Then you're going to let go so it's sticking straight up at 90 degree angles, and you're done. Now, to fold it, you don't want to have it fold this way, because it'll just fall over and you stand up straight, it won't even roll. It's really hard to make it roll. It'll fall backwards, because the heavy side, you want it to be standing up straight, because it's top heavy and it'll fall forward. So there it is, tumbler.